हेलो गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड। आई एम वैशाली की कान एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग द वीएलएसआई टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग द केमिकल मैकेनिकल पॉलिशिंग और द सीएमपी, एंड दिस इज द नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑन द सीएमपी। एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक इन डिटेल अबाउट द पोस्ट सीएमपी क्लीनिंग। So in the previous videos, we have already talked about some basic topics about the CMP, its process, its hardware as well. So some of you might be confused that I might have discussed the post-CMP cleaning with the CMP hardware itself. No, this topic is really important, right? So in this topic, we are going to talk separately about the cleaning method which is done after the chemical mechanical polishing. This topic is as important as the chemical mechanical polishing itself. So let's understand why I am saying so throughout this video. But before watching this video, it is highly recommended that you go back and watch the previous videos on the CMP at least, so that you will be understanding what I am saying when I am going to refer some previous topics, right? So as of now, I am considering that you have seen or watched all of the previous videos on CMP. So now why I am doing the post CMP cleaning? To remove the particulate materials which are present on the surface, or to remove the other contaminants which are present on the surface of the wafer as well. So to remove both of them, I am using the post CMP cleaning. So if I am not doing the post CMP cleaning, the defects would be generated. Right, I was using slurry for the chemical mechanical polishing of the wafer, and the slurry was containing some chemical compounds and it was containing some particulate matter as well. So the byproducts were also there, so all of them are going to act as a contaminant, and if I am not going to remove these contaminants, defects would be caused, the yield would be reduced. So we can do the mechanical scrubbing with the deionized water cleaning for the post CMP cleaning, right? If I am using more deionized water volume and I am using higher brush pressure, then I will be getting higher cleaning efficiency. So it's a common sense. If I am using more water, if I am using more pressure to clean something, it is going to clean more. Okay, it will be giving me more efficiency of the cleaning. So here in the cleaning, we will be having three basic steps, that is cleaning, rinsing and drying. First of all, we are going to clean the wafer, then we are going to rinse all of the output after the cleaning, so that there will be no particulate or the contaminant left on the wafer, and after that I am going to dry it, right? So all of them we are going to discuss in this video. So usually brush is made of porous polymers, which is going to allow the chemical to penetrate through it, and this is how it is going to deliver these chemical to the wafer. So I am going to show you the structure of the brush also. We can use the double sided scrubbers also in the post CMP cleaning process. So you can see this is how our brush system would be looking like. Here we have the brush and this is the core, and from here we are sending the deionized water as well as the chemicals to this brush, and this is how from this brush it is going to send the chemicals and the deionized water to the wafer. So now I have talked about the slurry. Slurry particles can chemically make the bond to the atoms on the wafer surface, and if slurry is dried, it is going to stick on the wafer surface. We can use the chemical additives like the NH4OH, we can use HF, or we can use the surfactants also to remove the bonded particles by weakening or breaking the bond. So now I have weakened or broken the bond, and now I am using the additives to help the particle to diffuse away from the surface, and this is how I will be removing all of the contaminant particles. So chemical solution will also be used to adjust the wafer and the particle surface charge, so that the electrostatic repulsion will be keeping the particle from redepositing on the surface, right? We don't want any electrostatic charge also to be present on the wafer, so we will be using the chemical solutions to adjust the charges over there, right? So we can use the acidic solution, which can be used to oxidize and dissolve the organic or the metallic particles over there. So now this is how we will be having the particle removal mechanism. Here we will be having the acidic solution in which I am doing the oxidation, and then we will be using the dissolution to remove the particle. So you can see this is our wafer surface. Okay, here this is my particle contaminant, and first of all I am doing the oxidation, and then I am going to dissolute this particle inside the acidic solution. After that we can also use the alkaline solution. The alkaline solution is going to do the surface etching as well as the electronic repulsion removal. So right here you can see we have the surface over which we have this contaminant particle. First of all we are giving the alkaline solution, as I have discussed in the previous slide also. So the alkaline solution is going to adjust the wafer and the particle surface charges also, so that the electronic repulsion will be keeping the particle from the redeposition on the surface. So this particle is not coming back on the given surface also. So this is the particle. So you can see we have removed or etched away the contaminant particle. So now coming to the silica particles. Silica particles are going to adhere or embed inside the oxide surface. So we can use here the alkaline chemicals to remove the silica particles. We can use NH4OH for the post-oxide CMP cleaning of the silica particles. The alkaline solution charges both silica particle as well as oxide surface negatively. So when the silica is negative charged, oxide surface is negative charged, they are going to apply the repulsive force on each other. So electrostatic force expels the particle from the surface, right? So wherever I have silica, I am going to use the alkaline solution. So HF is used, hydrofluoric acid is used to remove the particle with strong molecular bond with the surface. HF is a very strong acid. So here if I have a strong molecular bond with the surface, a strong acid will be used. So breaking the bond, dissolving silica particles and some other oxide surface will be done with the help of HF. So we can use the megasonics in which we have the megahertz ultrasound wave, which is used to release shock waves that are going to help dislodge the particles away from the wafer. So megasonics is another technique in which I am using the ultrasound wave in the megahertz frequency to release the shock waves, and this is going to dislodge the particle, and after that we are going to do the deionized water rinse. Coming to the post tungsten CMP cleaning, tungsten slurries are much harder to remove than the oxide slurries. The oxide slurries were easier to remove. We can use the alkaline solution, we can use the acidic solution, right, depending upon the silica presence or not. So deionized water with ammonium hydroxide NH4OH is commonly used for the post tungsten CMP clean. We can use the FeNO33 as the oxidant, which is going to result in the high iron ion concentration in the solution. So when I have higher iron ion concentration in the solution, the iron ion interacts with the hydroxyl ion to form FeOH3 particulate that grow to 1 micron thickness as well. So now this FeOH3 particle can cause high surface defect density, and it is going to contaminate the brush itself. So this is called the brush loading. When I am using high iron ions, it is going to react with the hydroxyl ion. It is going to form the FeOH3, which is going to contaminate the brush because it is having the high defect density, and this is called the brush loading. The defect caused with FeOH3 particle can be reduced by using 100:1 hydrofluoric clean solution. Okay, after that we have to use again the deionized water rinse. Now coming to the wafer drying, I have now cleaned the wafer, now I have rinsed the wafer with the deionized water. Now coming to the drying, so we are going to do the residue free drying process, right? We are going to physically remove without water evaporation all of the deionized water that is left on the wafer. So evaporation drying will be causing the contamination by leaving the dissolved chemicals in the deionized water behind. Right, so whenever I'm rinsing, I will be having some dissolved chemical present in the deionized water left on the wafer. If I'm going to evaporate this deionized water is going to evaporate, but the dissolved chemical is going to precipitate on the wafer and it is going to form the contaminant particle on the wafer. So it is going to reduce the wafer yield. Right, so that we don't want. So the most commonly used technique is spin drying. We are not using the evaporation drying, we are using the spin drying. So we can use the centrifugal force. Centrifugal force is going to drive the water out from the wafer. We can also do the ultra cleaning with dry air as well as the nitrogen flow to remove the water from the wafer center as well. So now coming to the vapor drying. We can do the vapor drying as well. Here we can use the ultra pure solvent with high vapor pressure. So which solvent is used? The most commonly solvent that is used is IPA. What is IPA? IPA is isopropyl alcohol, which is C3H8O. So it is going to displace water from the wafer surface. So this is how we are going to dry the wafer. So now coming to the dry in dry out CMP. So what is dry in dry out CMP? It is the integrated CMP as well as post CMP system, which is called the dry in dry out process. The CMP, post CMP clean as well as wafer drying is done in single sequence over here. So we are drying in as well as drying out, right? So here, because at the output we are drying also the wafer, so this is the reason it is called dry in dry out process. So it is going to improve the process throughput as well as the yield. So these are the references, these are some books which are really amazing. If you want to further read about this topic, you can refer these books. Okay, so these are amazing books that we have. If you have any doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment and I am going to revert as soon as possible. I hope you like this session. If you like it, please push the like button, subscribe to the channel and also do share it with your friends. Thank you so much.